Them other guys, irrelevant. They all on. Zoe Kravitz, half white, half melanin. Baby face and a white gold tooth cap. I treat the waiter nice, she loved that. I mix the blueberry pie. It's not what I wear, it's how I rock that. If I can buy that twice, I'll cut that. Sweet one, 10-10, spot that, chop that. Tryna lock me, I have to tell her it's not that. Do the he say, she say. Getting no delay, run it like relay, bro. You ain't going like this. In my part, see straight, big fur jacket from eBay, looking timeless. I gotta let my skin fade, marinate. We gotta toast up, celebrate. Everyone scream next up, but I'm the number one candidate. I'm a number one, like you say, set pace. Used to kick ball on the estate back then. T90s with the Levi's matching. Rips in the denim, that's classic. These beats get wrapped like Futamaki, that's a sushi roll. I'm a young CEO, gotta do as you're told. Got at your stack, gotta play your role. I was OT, all shutting down shows from A to B, long way to go. About time they know about me. Hello, the jiggle and clap, jello. I've been on top, where they at? Below, presidential flow, Marilyn Monroe. I got pounds, got euros, stacking them both. I'll stick. Do the he say, she say. Getting no delay, run it like relay, bro. You ain't going like this. In my part, see straight, big fur jacket from eBay, looking timeless. I gotta let my skin fade, marinate. We gotta toast up, celebrate. Everyone scream next up, but I'm the number one candidate. Captain's on, man, I'm making key plays. When I'm doing shows, gotta get all prepaid. Thought you, I'm on a break, no side, no about these ways. I gotta let my skin fade, marinate. We gotta toast up, celebrate. Everyone scream next up, but I'm the number one candidate. Number one.
The NFL is on EA Sports, and we are in Silicon Valley at Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. Today, two NFC clubs going head-to-head, as it'll be the Philadelphia Eagles taking on the San Francisco 49ers. Here's the Australian-born punter, Mitch Wishnowsky, to get things going.
And we are underway from Santa Clara.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Throwing right away. Oh, the first play of the game going to be intercepted. It's Jair Brown who's got it inside the 20.
Wow, just one snap there, partner, and the complexion of this game has already changed, because for the defensive side, they just handed their offense a short field and a big early advantage. And even though it's only the first snap of the game, we're going to look back on this one and see if it has lasting effects as this game moves on.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. Up the gut, McCaffrey. And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18. And that's a loss of 7 on the first down play.
You see that celebration from him after that stop? those corners don't normally have the chance to get behind the line of scrimmage and hand them big losses. So when he got that opportunity, he certainly made it a memorable one.
Now, after the loss, he'll have to navigate a second and 17.
Ayuk gonna go in motion right. Another run with McCaffrey on second down. Pushing his way through.
And he's gonna be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. They had great starting position to begin the drive, but now they look up at a 3rd and 5.
Throwing here, Purdy.
They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. And inside the 5 here before he's out of bounds right at the 3. And the screen only good for 3 that time, and it'll bring up a 4th down.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit. So Purdy off and Moody on for the 49er field goal.
From the left hash, a chip shot here. And this one is right through. And the 49ers take a 3-0 lead.
So golden field position there squandered as they can muster only a field goal.
Yeah, you were gifted a first and goal situation, but I have to give credit to the defense. They were brought out in a really tough situation, so give them credit for holding them to 3. That's a pretty nice accomplishment.
The 35. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38.
Play action. Here's Hurts.
And the Niners get there and bring him down. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a 2nd down and 17.
Hurts.
And that's caught inside the 35. Touchdown, Eagles. Dallas Goedert, 69 yards.
And the Eagles are able to answer the early 3 points and take a first quarter lead.
Elliott good on the extra point, and that makes it a 7-3 lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away.
They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put 6 on the board. That's a consolation prize. Like going to the county fair, you don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. On 1st down, this is McCaffrey. Now he's free at the 35. And all the way down to the 17-yard line. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on 1st down. Now Purdy. He's going to be sacked back in the 23-yard line.
Buried for the sack by big Jalen Carter.
And it's never good to take a sack. You really don't want to take one down here in this part of the field down near the red zone.
Not at all, because you're already pretty much assured of a field goal. But you take a big sack, it could push you out of range, and that's why defenses get a little more aggressive in this situation. They're almost conceding the 3 points. They want to push you back and try and take you out of there.
And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. That'll be a gain of 16, and they'll be faced with a third and inches.
Purdy now to throw off the play action. Able to find the open man. That's complete. Touchdown. George Kittle, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the 49ers are able to move back in front.
This is why a lot of play callers love play action in this spot. You just want to freeze the linebackers just for a second. Then you got a chance to get a quick pass into your tight end right behind them for a touchdown.
Moody good with the extra point. 10-7 our score after one right here on the East.
Ready to kick it away, and here we go. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Off the play fake, here's Hurts. This short throw caught by Goddard. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. Second and 6, just inside the 30.
Second and 6, at the 29-yard line.
They go play action with Hurts.
And down he goes, the 49ers get there.
Nick Bosa so quick on the outside, he gets in there to bring him down.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
The object there was to get the ball to him on a quick slant, see if he could get loose and take one the distance. But the defense was prepared, and incompletion results.
They're going on fourth down with Hurts.
He's going to look deep for Watkins. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. A surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And boy, possession here turns over with a football already being in the red zone.
He'll get this out right here to McCaffrey.
And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. This is McCaffrey on the give. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. A 5-yard gain there makes it first and goal.
They were not fooling around at all, were they? Second and short, and they brought out the heavy package. Almost felt like the super heavy package against that defense, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they expected that much beef up front, and it turned into an easy first down conversion. From the 2 now, second and goal.
McCaffrey is going backwards as he'll be tackled back at the 4-yard line.
It's a loss of 2, now third down.
That was well played there defensively. 2 tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Now Purdy, he's going to change the look here.
Two minutes remaining in the first half, 10-7, our score. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Again, they run again. It's McCaffrey. It looks like he's going to be stopped short of the first down by about a yard. This defense bending but not breaking. It's a gain of three. It's now fourth and goal. Well, let's see what they do. They're knocking on the door here in the second quarter.
And you know what you look at on your play sheet? Your two-point conversion plays. Because you've drawn up a number of them in today's football. You don't just have one or two for the game. You have more like six or seven. Which one do you like here? Because that's essentially what you're going for right now. That spot of the field, call one of those and go get six.
So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. So Purdy off and Moody on for the 49er field goal.
From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And his kick is good. And the lead stretches to six here. It's 13-7. Well, in a close game like this, obviously you want the touchdown, but certainly they will take the three.
And they'll be okay with that, but let's throw a little credit to the defense as well. And I'm just glad this doesn't come down to a debate, right? Which side won, partner? Because the defense, hey, we didn't give up a touchdown. The offense, hey, we put three on the board. Either way you look at it, I think both sides gained something out of that drive.
But first down, Hurts. This short throw caught by Goddard. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And that'll give him a short yardage situation here for second down.
Hurts sets up to throw it.
Escaping the pressure right. Hurts dangerous when he runs that football. He's got a first. Now a timeout called for by the offense, as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. They'll throw on first down with Hurts. Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked up by Diamador Lenore. And the 49ers are going to take over at their own 41. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And with good starting field position and three timeouts as well in their pocket, no reason not to try and put a late scoring drive together. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. Now second and three. They'll give it up to McCaffrey, and he'll get it down to the 47 here. And they're going to speed things up here. They'll bring one of the tight ends in motion left. On first down, it's Purdy. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18.
Yeah, looks like they'll move things around here.
From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory. And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half.
Here's Purdy now on third and goal.
This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. And he is out of bounds inside the 35.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight end, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds it for the first down.
And his kick is right there. It's good, and that will do it for this first half. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. It's the 49ers out in front, and they will get the football first as well as we are back and started in the second half. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. But Charles, for them, pretty good first half on the ground. They had some success running the ball in quarters one and two, and they've got the lead. Now a chance to expand upon that lead here with their first drive in the third quarter.
Yeah, believe it or not, you and I have noticed that this great game of football has shifted towards pass first, run second. So for me, it's really nice to see some of these teams keeping the ground game as a big component of their offense, and it's working pretty well for them now. And let's face it, they can continue to do damage with it. And in addition, it sets up the pass game really well for them, too.
A throw to the middle, taken in. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. And quickly, they get to the line. Play action, now Purdy. And his throw is incomplete.
I know tight ends love this route because a lot of times they'll fake a block first and get a little bit of space and then come across the middle because in their mind, they're thinking catch the ball and then drop the hammer on the little guys in the secondary.
Unable to drop the hammer, he just dropped the pass. Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete.
Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletion. They're going for more.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. And he'll get this only to about the 38 as they stop him a few yards shy of the line to gain.
A gain of 6 yards. It's fourth down.
Purdy on fourth down. Pass taken in by his big tight end. Touchdown, 49ers. George Kittle, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the 49ers' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Moody good with the extra point. And that could be important as that makes this a 16-point lead. Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Well, the opposition laid down the challenge and opening drive touchdown here to start the second half. And Charles, now you feel like this group needs to get an answer because this all of a sudden is a two-score game.
Yeah, you're right about that. What was a small, manageable spread to overcome? A little bit more daunting now. I think you're exactly right. Pressure is on because you don't want them getting the ball back with a chance to really extend this lead out.
Here's Hurts to throw. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo.
It's a gain of 25 yards.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And Hurts is intercepted, his third of the game. Picked up.
She keep looking at me like she feeling me. Girl, the way you be moving, the stuff you be doing, you tripping out and it's killing me. Man, I swear to God, you be tripping. I can't even do it. My girl, I'm Tiffany. Damn, and she trying to cut me off. No, she cannot do it. No, she cannot scissor me. Mark your spot, that boy get. Don't send him a car, he finna get blessed on. I get the pay, but I'm talking about Benjamin Frank. Not talking about the one that you sketch on. He play dumb, get his gone. Hit a crib, but he loving on red bone. Now I'm hard to reach, I'm bout my cheese. I'm moving around with two phones. Move around like an island boy, but it ain't for the head, cause I keep me a vest on. Get down like the Backstreet Boys, cause it make you dance, but you better get your groove on.
Not talking about, but it's too strong, talking, then we get it started. Pull up in the U-Haul, you get your move
and
on.
And they know they ain't seeing us. You pull your pin in that double cup. Wanna step at yourself, are you good enough? Wanna step at yourself, are you hood enough? If I hit them Chris, know you pulling up. And now you laid out, ain't no getting up. I'm with your girl in the bathroom, and it sound like shit.
I tried a little boy, ain't no getting up. Shorty, your horsey, I told her they. My young city, oh. The granny, I had to tell her, pick it. You wanna feed, now. Anything under 18, just like. Man, from the club, she like 5'3. I think it ain't Lydia.
You know, unstoppable, man, it's impossible to stop as we for sure on the road. Stay to myself, stay off the medium. Chilling, ain't gonna play with the trolls. Going 100 in the I-8, I pray to God we don't lose control. Know I'm on a paper chase, my little whip on cruise control.
Since them days where we raved for 3 days and 4 nights and took them red eye flights, hopped straight off the plane and through the back door of the place. Then I sat down stage, they were like, see the car going ahead, they were like, so I sat down stage, they were like, raised by some Zulu lions, taught to seek dangers, brave and defiance, boy, the Lord was doing favors, blazed through the fire, yeah, we had a few, lost a few wages, still coming rampant, misbehaving, misbehaving, flavors, still coming anti-up, rebelling with my ravers, still don't give a f*** about who be the latest, can't be locked up in them cages, start living up to what the f*** you think of days.
But hey, what about the
so I stepped on stage, they were like, see the crowd going.
Comparing me to these rappers is disrespect. Who's the best MC? Cole, Kendrick, and me.